Also new tonight, a fund to help the boy accused of causing last week's lockdown in Orono has more than $32,000. Police arrested the boy last week for posting threats on social media of a shooting at Orono schools. A parent of another student created the GoFundMe campaign. They say the student arrested has autism and did not mean it. Boyd Hooper takes a look at the campaign.
More than $32,000 pledged and dozens of supportive comments for the family of a student with autism whose social media threats prompted a lockdown at Orono Public Schools.
Okay, now I just have to find mine.
Among the donors, Deb Spacito.
I'm with you on this journey to help any way I can. Please know that there are many who fight the same fight.
Deb's 15-year-old son Cooper has autism. She also has friends with children at Orono schools.
My heart breaks for that family and the people who had, you know, the kids, the staff, the families who waited out in the car for their kids. And I mean, I can't imagine. I can't imagine any of them. I just can relate to the woman, the family that has the autistic child.
Supportive comments from the autism community, but also from the Orono school community.
I think it's very positive that the people who know this family and know this young man in the community can see him for who he is, who was a young man who made a mistake and did something impulsively that was probably foolish, but not as a danger or someone to be thrown away.
On other social media platforms, some commenters disparaged the fundraiser, demanding both child and parents be held accountable.
That just crushed me. Like, you don't know what we go through.
Deb Spacito wishes she could have done more.
Yeah. I wish I could give that mom a hug.
Back to that GoFundMe campaign, the organizer writes that the money will go to the family's medical and legal needs, along with the parents' lost wages.
All right. Thank you, Boyd. Mm-hmm.